Hey everyone, I'm going to be doing a review on Glitter Utilities. This is the version 5.64.0.85, and I just updated not too long ago, so it's on the latest version. What Glitter Utilities does, it helps get rid of any bad registries or leftover registries that were not removed in other programs. Helps get rid of shortcut, it fixes shortcuts that aren't broken, so it just gets rid of them, or actually fixes them real quick. Spell remover, actually let's uncheck that, because it never really finds anything, so I use Malwarebytes for that. Don't need to do disk repair, because my hard drive is still good, but if your hard drive is acting a little funny, that maybe it's running slower or something like that, you can probably use disk repair. Track eraser gets rid of like cookies and other cache stuff like that, so I look up that up. So that's what it does. Temporary files, and we're gonna need startup. So we're gonna do a scan. We're just gonna let this run and see how much it finds. So what it does is this is the one click maintenance, and then you just click one click maintenance, and then you just do a scan, and it's gonna find, which has found 34. Let's see about the shortcuts. But while this is scanning, I'm just gonna say is that I've not cleaned my computer for the past like 2 weeks, and it's been so cringing that I normally do this about once a week, and I just want to show you guys like how pretty easy and pretty simple this is. This is free. You can get the premium, which they have sales a lot of half off and sorts. You can get for like 10, maybe 20 bucks. I think it's a year. I don't recall. But it's a pretty good software. A friend recommended it to me, and I've been using it ever since. The only difference between with this and CCleaner is that CCleaner cleans some things that I did not want to clean up. So I did not like that. So I probably have to find an option for that part or something. But CCleaner is good. But I like their utilities just because it's simple and easy. And you can go into this advanced options or advanced tools here, and we call it in. If you know what you're doing, you can use that and clean additional stuff. I think I can still click there while scanning. Yes, I can. So this is what you'll probably normally see. Oh yeah, it tells you your boot time. Like it'll take me about a minute, but I think that's a little inaccurate. Okay, look, it's done. Cool. So I found that's about 34 gigs because I've put everything in the trash bin. I found one problem here. It's going to get rid of like almost 9,000 problems with all the stuff. And let's just do repair. So again, in advanced tools there, so you can do your own registry, defragment, and disk space cleanup. I see you can probably easily do remove duplicates. You can find any duplicates of the exact same file name that you may have a second copy of, and it'll tell you the date difference. So has pretty good intelligence system on that. You can remove empty folders. Doesn't take a lot of space, but when you have thousands or like hundreds of thousands of empty folders all over, it does add up. I apologize for this. This is actually my antivirus program. This is telling me that it wants to make changes, so I'm just gonna say don't show me again, and allow all. There it goes. So, as you can see, was explaining that a problem solved. Now it's getting rid of temporary files cleaner. Probably is going to become empty now. But yeah, I like it. It's simple. Updates here. I forgot to mention while this is cleaning up. If you actually click it, it tells you to like what programs are up to date. They have like a whole, like, there's like Java, there's Adobe. I wouldn't really do it, just wait until Adobe Flash tells you to update or Java tells you to update, because the ones that they have is always the alpha or beta stages of that version, and it could break or mess up whatever you're using or doing, or like Minecraft or something. So yeah, and I've been using this for about, I don't know, 2 years now, and I've never really had any problems with it. Like I said, I like it. It's simple, easy, free to use. Oh, and the premium version does its all it really does, the major key, is that it allows you to pretty much download the newest update without going to a website. And I think a couple other things, I'm not sure, but yeah. Well, it looks like it's almost done. But yeah, so one last thing I want to say is I am not being sponsored or affiliated with Glarisoft, which is the company who that makes Clarity. So I'm doing this on my own behalf of doing a review on this. So then you guys can easily clean your computer. Like I said, I'm not gonna say this is highly recommended. This is just something that alternative to what I used in CCleaner. So, yeah. Oh, you can tell if let's say if this was gonna take a while, you saw shut down there and automatically close, but that's if it's gonna take all a very long time. This normally does not take more than 5 to 10 minutes, if tops. I mean, it only took what, maybe about 6 minutes or so or something. But yep. So there you go. I had a pretty big amount of space that I did not have much left here, but kind of cleaned it up. I was kind of in the red. I was parking roughly right here, so probably clean up definitely 36 gigs. So I wish I did it before that. Wow. But anyways, I hope you enjoy this, like it. Then go ahead and get it. It's on gonna be. You can just Google, Glare Utilities. It's gonna be on the first link, and then just click download and done install. And there you go. Oh, and yeah. Okay, well guys, hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you next time.